being none, I am going to speak to something that came up at last month's the May board meeting, when a question was asked by a resident saying that why the board voted to suspend a particular attendance item. It was District Policy 5441, Student Athletic Extracurricular Activity Participation, and it was suspended for the month of December 2010. I'm going to let Mr. Papiti speak to that, and I don't see the gentleman here this evening, so I will make sure that the board clerk gives him something in writing in response to his question. Mr. Papiti?
Thank you, Madam President. At our November policy meeting, the executive principal at NFA and the athletic director came to the policy committee and requested a quick change to the participation policy, because with the enhanced capability of Infinite Campus, they were able to capture the 90% requirement in real time, and the existing policy depended on an end of the month report from the 10X system that we were on, and imposed a 30-day suspension after that time until the next report to see whether or not the student had reattained the 90% requirement. Infinite Campus allowed that to be immediate, both at the time when they could be suspended, when they fell below the 90% threshold, and then when they regained the 90% threshold and became re-eligible. So because we wanted to go to that system, the policy was to be amended and then voted on at the November meeting immediately, because it was affecting the upcoming sports seasons. When we got to the board meeting, our attorney had been unable to complete the revised policy and was unable to attend that evening, so we were unable to vote for the amendment that was due. And because it would have affected anyone during the course of December who might have fallen below the policy, that would have had to wait the entire time for the 30 days to be up, which was not the intent of the revision, it was decided at that time to just go ahead, since December's a short month anyway with vacation, to go ahead and suspend the existing policy for the month of December, just so that we could get the actual policy rewritten and taken care of, which was done at the December meeting, and everything returned to normal.
Thank you, Mr. Papiti. Be it resolved that the board hereby recesses into executive session for the following purposes: to discuss the employment history of particular individuals and to discuss collective negotiations under the Taylor Law. The board will not be taking action after executive session. Can I have a motion?
I move.
Second.
Roll call.
Mr. DeMarco?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Cavetti?
Yes.
Mr. Perkins?
Yes.
Mrs. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bessie?
Yes.
Mrs. Kuchinek?
Yes. Thank you all for coming and being here with us this evening, and especially thank you to those of you who stayed for the entire meeting.
Okay.